Representative Corbett, as a member of Natural Resources and Environment Committee, I was going to ask if you could give us an update on the lawsuit between Georgia, Florida, and Alabama over water rights.
Definitely. I'm on the Natural Resources and Environment Committee, and as such, I've been around the state on several study committees this past year. Over Savannah, we had a committee meeting on saltwater intrusion. Basically, what that is when you're taking more water out of the aquifer that can replenish itself, you create a cone of depression which allows salt water to seep in. It's already happened in Charleston, South Carolina, and we're doing everything we can to make sure it doesn't happen in Savannah on the coast in Georgia. Also, we learned about aquifer storage and recovery. Basically, that's where you pump water from one aquifer, store it in another aquifer that's closer to the surface to be used at a later date. They drilled two wells in southwest Georgia. One of them didn't yield results they anticipated. A second one 8 miles from there yielded a lot better results, so it seems to be site-specific. In a soil and water conservation meeting in Tifton, we was given an update on the lawsuit that you're talking about. And basically what it is, Alabama and Florida is saying Georgia's using too much water, not allowing enough water to flow downstream for their uses. If the judge rules against Georgia, first thing I see it happening, you know, and tells us we got to allow so many gallons flow downstream, that water has to come from the Flint or the Chattahoochee. Both of those are in southwest Georgia. It can have an immediate impact on the farmers in that area on the amount of surface water that they're able to use for irrigation, which can hurt agriculture, which is Georgia's number one industry. The other thing, you know, Atlanta, and what they tell me, Atlanta's sitting on a big rock. And unless your name's Moses, you can't get water out of a rock. So they depend on surface water for all of their needs. So it can definitely hurt economic development in and around Atlanta. So they'll have to come up with alternate sources of water supplies, which probably be additional reservoirs. We have to do interbasin and intrabasin transfers to fill that reservoir for rivers during times of high water levels to fill those up. There is a lawsuit that Georgia's probably going to file against Tennessee over the landline in the northwest corner of Georgia. The description of it is the 35th parallel. The actual land where it's surveyed back in the 1800s, about a mile south of there. Georgia actually, if on the 35th parallel, has access to the Tennessee River. That will become a lot more important. You know, no matter what the court decides going forward, you know, water as a natural resource has become a lot more valuable. We're about to make wise decisions to be able to meet the needs of a growing population and a growing economy here in Georgia. Thank you.
Thank you. Senator Black, I intend.